Queen Mary nearing New York on her maiden voyage. And those of you who have ever enjoyed American hospitality can imagine the welcome in store for her, the debutante of the seas. Americans, for all their critical attitude, have a very genuine affection for the old country. And I believe they are delighted to see Britain challenging again for her old supremacy in the passenger traffic of the Atlantic. What a marvelous spectacle is the mass of New York City, clustered at the south tip of Manhattan Island. New York is lucky in being a seaport at the terminus of the world's greatest ocean route. Thus, the greatest ships in the world pass right up her river under the shadow of the skyscrapers. Then commences the task of maneuvering the great vessel alongside, and the mammoth has to be guided by pygmy tugs. So ends the maiden trip. She did not break the Normandy's record as fog delayed her. For some time, she will not allow her engines to develop full power, but when that time comes, Normandy, look to your laurels.
After 5 days in New York, we hear that the Queen Mary has put to sea again, and that her bows are headed homeward. We fly out with Jack Carter to meet her, and as we circle around, another member of the fleet passes, the Berengaria, outward bound. This is one of those unique pictures which is memorable in newsreel annals. Two great vessels passing at sea. And now the Queen Mary begins to dock at Southampton. Welcome home, great lady. Many prosperous voyages in the future, and many happy returns to your home waters.